What we have done in the previous module is motivate the idea of numerical integration and used a geometric interpretation of what numerical integration means. Specifically, we considered two methods. One was the Euler's method and the second one was trapezoidal method. In trapezoidal method, what we did was we tried to approximate the area under the curve as approximately equal to area under a trapezoid. So, what the geometric interpretation of the trapezoidal method was is if we plot f of x against x and if we get say some kind of an arbitrary curve of this sort and we want to integrate it from let us say x 1 to x 2, what we do is we just connect these two points by a straight line and now area under the trapezoid that is formed over here is the area under the curve. Okay. So, that is what we studied in the previous lecture. This is really the geometric interpretation of trapezoidal rule. Based on this particular geometric interpretation, we said that the integral I using the trapezoidal rule was equal to half multiplied by x2 minus x1. We called this x2 minus x1 as h. So, h by 2 multiplied by f of x2 plus f of x1, or I'll just write that as y2 plus y1, and this is the area under the trapezoid. It's half multiplied by the base multiplied by sum of the two heights. That was the geometric interpretation of the trapezoidal rule. So, what we are going to do today is try to formalize a couple more ways of deriving the trapezoidal rule, and the first one is again directly motivated by this geometric interpretation. So, what we are doing is we are joining a line that passes through two points. The two points are x1, y1 and x2, y2. Okay. What I am assuming over here is y equals f of x. So, rather than writing every time f in brackets x, f in bracket x and some things like that, I will just write it as y. Okay. And we are interested in finding integral of y dx from x1 to x2, or in general from a to b. Okay, that is the problem that we are trying to solve. So, our integral I is going to be equal to integral from x1 to x2 of y dx. Okay. So, this is the exact integral that we intend to find. The approximate integral based on the trapezoidal rule is really the area under the trapezoid. So, we will write that as approximately equal to x1 to x2, and just to use some other notation, I will use say y hat dx, okay, where y hat is nothing but the equation for this particular line. Okay. So, now this particular line, the equation for that is going to be essentially y minus y1 divided by x minus x1 equal to y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Okay. Or in other words, we take x minus x1 and multiply it throughout and we just rearrange that, we will be able to write y equal to y1 plus x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1 multiplied by y2 minus y1. Okay. And because we are representing this as y hat, I will just put the hat signs over here. Okay. So, now what the area under that trapezoid is nothing but integral of this particular part dx from x1 to x2. So we will just substitute that over here. So we have integral from x1 to x2 y1 plus x minus x1 times alpha, or rather than using alpha, I'll need the term alpha later on, so I'll just call it instead of that something beta. Okay, so y plus x minus x1 beta times dx, where beta I have just called this as y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Okay, so when we integrate this, we are going to get y1 minus x1 beta, that is the constant, multiplied by x going from x1 to x2, okay, plus beta multiplied by x square by 2 from x1 to x2. Okay, so y minus x1 times beta is a constant. Integral y minus x1 beta dx is y minus x1 beta multiplied by x. The limits of integration are from x1 to x2, and likewise here we have beta multiplied by x. This term, when we integrate that, it is going to be beta x square divided by 2 going from x1 to x2. Okay, so let us substitute those values in there. So I is going to be approximately equal to y1 minus x1 beta multiplied by x2 minus x1. Okay, plus I will have beta by 2 x2 squared minus x1 squared. I will substitute the value of beta over here in a moment. I will just write it down. We have y1 multiplied by x2 minus x1, I will call that as h. Okay, x2 minus x1 is this distance h, so I will just substitute that over there. So I will have y1 multiplied by h minus x1 y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1, that was the value beta. Multiplied by x2 minus x1, this gets cancelled, plus y2 minus y1 divided by 2 times x2 minus x1 multiplied by, so x2 squared minus x1 squared, I will write that x2 plus x1, x2 minus x1, and the x2 minus x1 will get cancelled. Okay, so we have y1 multiplied by h minus x1 y2 plus x1 y1 plus y2 minus y1 divided by 2 multiplied by x2 plus x1. Okay, so this we will be able to expand this as y2 x2 by 2 minus y1 x2 by 2 plus y2 x1 by 2 minus y1 x1 by 2. Okay, plus x1 y1. Okay, and we have x1 y1 by 2 and x1 y1 over here, so this will get cancelled, and we will just divide this particular guy by 2. We have x1 y2 and we have this x1 y2, so this will get cancelled, and we will just be able to divide this by 2. Okay, so we will write this as y1h, okay, minus y1 multiplied by x, so we will plus y1 by 2, we will look at these two terms, and that is x1 minus x2, okay, plus y2, and then we will look at these two terms, and that is going to be y2 divided by 2 multiplied by minus x1 plus x2, okay. Minus x1 plus x2 is nothing but h, and x1 minus x2 is nothing but minus h. So we have y1h minus y1h by 2 plus y2 by 2 multiplied by h, okay. And that we will be able to write, this will get cancelled and this becomes y1h by 2, we will be able to write this as h by 2 multiplied by y1 plus y2, okay. So the integral I using trapezoidal method is written as I using the trapezoidal method is h by 2 multiplied by y1 plus y2. If we go back and look at the geometric derivation, that is exactly what we had obtained as the integral I using the trapezoidal method, okay. So the trapezoidal method, the sense of it is you take two data points, connect those two data points by a straight line and find the integral under that straight line. The third method we will use is based on Newton's forward difference formula. Okay. And if we recall the Newton's forward difference formula for two data points was nothing but y1 plus alpha multiplied by delta y1 plus so on and so forth, right. So if you were to write a polynomial y of alpha, okay, then we would be able to write this as y1 plus alpha times delta y1 plus alpha multiplied by alpha minus 1 times delta squared y1 divided by 2 factorial plus alpha, alpha minus 1, alpha minus 2 delta cubed y1 divided by 3 factorial plus dot dot dot, okay. So depending on how many data points that we have, we will be able to write it as a longer series. Now when we have just two data points, we are going to retain only the first two terms. For the Newton's forward difference formula, we had alpha was equal to x minus x1 divided by the h, which is delta x is nothing but h in this particular case. So it was x minus x1 divided by h. So therefore when we differentiate this, we will get d alpha equal to dx by h, or dx equal to h times d alpha, okay. So this is what we will get when we substitute the value of dx in terms of d alpha, okay. So let us recall what integral I was. Integral I was going from x1 to x2, integral of y hat, y hat x dx, that was the approximate value of the integral, okay. When it comes to the trapezoidal rule, x1 is corresponds to alpha equal to 0, you substitute x1 over here, we get alpha equal to 0, you substitute x2, we get alpha equal to 1. So based on the based on the Newton's polynomial, we will have the integral going from 0 to 1. Y hat is y1 plus alpha delta y1 okay. So that is going to be our polynomial multiplied by dx, dx is h times d alpha okay. And now we do the integration and we will get this as h multiplied by y1 alpha and alpha going from 0 to 1 plus delta y1 multiplied by integral alpha dx, and alpha dx is going to be alpha squared by 2, again going from 0 to 1, okay. And this is going to be nothing but h multiplied by alpha is going from 0 to 1 is going to be 1 minus 0, so it is just going to be y1 plus delta y1 was nothing but y2 minus y1 multiplied by alpha squared by 2, so that is 1 minus 0 divided by 2, so that is going to be 1 by 2, okay. So therefore, we have y1 plus y2 by 2 minus y1 by 2. Y1 minus y1 by 2 is going to be plus of y1 by 2. So therefore, we will have this as equal to h multiplied by y1 plus y2 divided by 2, okay. When we do this derivation, we find that the final value of the integral was the same that we obtained using our geometric or our algebraic methods for joining the two points with a straight line, okay. Now the question is, why did I go through an additional method in order to figure out what the same integral is? The reason I went through this additional method is because the Newton's forward difference formula, using the Newton's forward difference formula, we can figure out what the leading error term is, okay. So when we are just using two data points, if we had an additional third data point, our polynomial would be even more accurate, but we are not using this additional third data point, and that additional point that we are actually throwing away is going to give us an idea of what the error of this particular method is, okay. So the error of this method, and this was something that I did not cover in the previous lecture, using mean value theorem, actually it can be proved that the terms that we are discarding away from this point onwards, the error E is of the order of alpha multiplied by alpha minus 1 divided by 2 factorial f double dash of x. That's what it can be proved. So error in the trapezoidal method is of the order of integral from x1 to x2, or integral from 0 to 1, alpha multiplied by alpha minus 1 divided by 2 f double dash of zeta, okay. And dx will be replaced by h d alpha, okay. And in addition to that, each of these is associated with h for this particular guy and h for this particular guy. So we will have an h square term over here, okay. This is the standard error in Newton's forward difference polynomial, okay. So the error for trapezoidal method is of the order of h cube by 2 multiplied by integral from 0 to 1 alpha square d alpha minus integral from 0 to 1 alpha d alpha, okay, which is equal to h cube by 2 multiplied by alpha cubed by 3 from 0 to 1 minus alpha squared by 2 going from 0 to 1, okay, which is h cube divided by 2 multiplied by 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2, okay. So that is 2 minus that is going to be 2 minus 3 divided by 6, so that is minus 1 by 6. So the error is going to be minus 1 by 12 h cube, and I have been forgetting f double dash zeta throughout, so I will just write that over here, multiplied by f double dash zeta and f double dash zeta, okay. So that is really the error when computing the integral using the trapezoidal rule.